Well, some people would say yes, and sometimes you don't get in, and other times you give 100%, and you get a call on Valentine's Day from Todd Stoll welcoming your school to Essentially Ellington finals in May of 2017.
What?
Wait, what the?
Wait.
What? Yo! Congratulations, we're going to New York.
Yeah!
When I first found out that I made Ellington, I freaked, you know, I just kind of jumped out of my chair.
The way I felt when I found out that our band made Ellington, I was kind of shocked. Not because I didn't believe that we could, but just the fact that we actually made it.
We had to do a lot of sectionals. We had to do a lot of rehearsals after school.
We listened to the music together on our free time. We had, like, times where we would shed together at each other's houses. Like, we lived through the music. And so I feel like that's what really helped us to get in.
Do not get arrested today. Do not start fights with TSA. Love you guys.
Once I got on the plane and we were in the air, I was like, just got serious, like, about to be in New York. Came from Kissimmee, now we're about to be in New York playing at Lincoln Center.
OCSA Jazz Band. Competition in Lincoln Center. We wish you the best of luck. Great job.
Yeah, thank you.
When we landed in New York, well, first of all, physically, it felt like my ears were popping. When we landed, and you know, just looking around, everything was so like exciting. We were just, you know, we just started making raps and taking videos, doing live streams, and everything was just so exciting. But then, you know, little by little, I started to get really tired because, you know, it was a long day.
I was tired, so we came outside, and now the weather has kind of invigorated me. Excited to be in New York, Big Apple, and I'm excited.
I was looking forward most to go to the city, just the vibe that the city has. It's uncomparable.
It was cool, yeah. It took a while to get used to New York, but I actually like the vibe that it has.
We are here, we are at the Ellington Festival, getting ready to do the walk-in, going to be introduced. I'm super excited to be here with the group. This has been a vision of ours since we made it the last time, to make it back. We're super excited to be here today.
It felt great. Everybody, like, we felt that everybody was, like, there to swing, there to just play music, to hear each other. It was really welcoming. And the jam sessions, each group that played with someone from Lincoln Center or one of the judges. And just like being able to play with them on the bandstand was just a great, great vibe. It was kind of unreal.
It was a lot of fun.
that first day, I definitely felt like our band belonged to be there amongst the other bands.
Like a center, and I was so scared that we were going to be the worst band there. We were just going to be sad. But once I started hearing, I realized why we were there. It was because we deserved it. We were there because we worked for it. And because we got there because we worked for it. And once I saw that, and I saw that everyone else was there because they worked for it, I just said, you know, it's we're here because we're here, and they're here because they're here. Because they deserved it, and because we worked for it, so I just we were all at the same level and the same place for the same reason.
So when Marcus Perna, we have a mentor, and when he first heard our band play, because we rehearsed before we actually performed, when he heard our band play the first song, he was in tears. He was explaining this whole long story about how he hasn't had a break since 3 weeks. He's been on the road, all this stuff. But I mean, that's what he said. That's what he lives for. And just the way that we played, the spirit that we gave out through the music, he just felt regenerated, and he was thankful that he didn't even have anything really to. Advice to give us on that first song. They were just in tears and thanked us for playing like that.
And what I want you to do today, and I told you we're not going to worry about first, second, third, 15th place. Yeah. What we need to do is go out there and share our spirit of jazz.
Preach.
Our love for the music and who we are. So we just need to go out there and be who you are. Do not try to be someone else. You be who you are and you're going to be fine. I invite you to join me. I am so excited. I wish we could have been playing already. I'm going to go out there and have fun. I hope you will join me.
Yes. 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 Yes.
May we shake the foundations of jazz at Lincoln Center. Whether we win or not, we've already won because we play together. Amen. Amen. Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I'll say that to God.
Let's go, guys.
Marcus Printup is such a respected musician in the jazz world, and he's an amazing player. And for us, like a high school band, to make a professional like tear up, that's a big deal.
I remember right before we entered the stage in the room when we were warming up, this guy came. He just had us chanting. He was like,
"Where you at?
The house is swaying.
Where you at?
The house is swaying.
What you come to do?
Swaying."
I feel like that was a real confidence booster. So when we went out there, I just, you know, I was striding on the stage, just ready to do my thing.
I definitely thought, like, when I got on stage, wow, this is where all the videos I watch online, like, they're all here.
Jazz Band A. Give
them
a welcome.
I was just so happy to be on that stage because that was, ever since I started, you know, really jumping into jazz, that's what I've always wanted to do, just play on that stage. And that was, just being on that stage, walking on, that was just enough.
We'd like to thank our administrators, Ms. Evans, Dr. Long and Mr. Connors, who's here. Without your support, we just wouldn't be here. So thank you for this crazy journey we've been on. Of course, our faculty, our staff, our students, especially all my jazz band students, I promise you I give you a shout out, so this is your shout out. And of course, each and every parent. And our first composition is Stay On It. It'll feature several members from the band. We're gonna start off with my performance, Chris McDowell Jr., Andres Adames on trumpet, Gabriel Logroño on bass or baritone sax, followed by Zacharia Antifit on guitar, and then two more, if I can remember them right now, would be Jonathan Aviles on tenor saxophone and Eric Gonzalez on trumpet. Stay on that.
Thank you.
feature on this second song on trumpet, Jose Valle, on the trombone, Diego Duval, and on clarinet, Jonathan Avilis. I find it interesting, I've asked several people, how do you pronounce this tune? And I always get a different response. So I'm just going to say it the way my grandma would say it in Spanish. This is Y San Luis Tululú. Welcome, Ms. Rosie Martinez and Bicala Band.
Bill Mullen, I know you're watching. I just want to say thank you so much. He's our co-band director. He deals with the concert bands. And I appreciate you. Hope your father's doing well today. Okay. I'd like to feature Danny Gavion on this last piece. We're going to play for you, of course, the two vocalists. Jonathan Aviles on tenor saxophone. Diego Duval again on trombone. And Eric Gonzalez from the trumpet section. This is our version of Night in Tunisia. Thank you.
feel like it definitely made people aware of what Osceola County School for the Arts and just the county itself represents.
After everything was over, it was a sense of relief because, yeah, we all had our butterflies in our stomachs knowing that we were going to go up there. But it was just being able to enjoy each other's presence knowing that we did something great.
Yeah, when we walked off, the first word that came out of my mouth, I remember I said, "We just did that." Those are my words. "We just did that. We just did that." Also, from Kissimmee, Florida, just did that. Because it was so amazing that we had just played at Frederick P. Rose Hall. Some small school in a no man's land in Kissimmee, Florida, just played on Frederick P. Rose Hall on that stage. And it was just, we did that. That's all it was. And just humbly, everything that happened there, I took it humbly, and I just took everything as a motivation to become even better. Everything that happened at that event was just motivation to be a better version of myself.
How did you feel when you shook Wynn?
That was legendary. Shaking Wynn Marsalis' hand is just something.
What really took my mind is the fact that I had such a great experience, and now that great experience is going to influence me to make myself a better person. So I got on that plane very hopeful, knowing that I came here back to Florida to improve because of the inspiration that I sought out and I found at Ellington. So yeah.
It was just overall just a really great experience. I mean, I don't know how the band's going to be this upcoming year, but I already know we're about to be on that stage for a second time, or a third time actually. But yeah, we're definitely coming back.
I want to be part of it, New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it, New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one. These little town blues, oh, start of it in old New York. And if I can make it there, I'm gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York.